utlwa bohloko ba ho lahlehelwa ke moratuwa. Re be re tiane le maemo a mangata a seng monate. Hangata, ditshenyehelo tsa lepato di ka siya ba setseng morao ba le mathateng a tjhelete. Ke nna Mmarona Kgwele, mme o shebeletse Rands with Sense. Gale amohela ho Rands with Sense. Lenane ho leetsang hore o seke wa tshaba ho bua ka mathata a hao a tjhelete. Ka jeno re bua ka taba e bohloko haholo e leng lefu le hore le ama maemo a rona a tjhelete jwang.
Ongelukkig is het zo dat de meeste mensen niet genoeg voorziening maken voor begrafeniskosten nie. Ek dink die publiek is net eenvoudig nie bewus van wat 'n begrafnis vandag kos nie.
A bare minimum that is required for a traditional funeral, it varies. We are kabukhoni huna li lifule as simple as 10,000 rand. Babang they go to an extent of spending boma 80,000-100,000 rand ka lifu, depending on hore kwa makase a jwang di casket di jo, you know, matsatsing ana ibile li traveling it also contribute to the costs tsa lifu.
Ja, die kusterreekse begin omtrent by aan die lae kant hierso by net so oor R1000 vir 'n kus en dit kan opgaan soos ek sê tot by meer as R200,000 vir die soliede braaskus wat ons al voorheen ingevoer het. Dis natuurlik heeltemal uitsonderlik en gewoonlik is die topreeks hier by R30,000. Die begrafniskoste bestaan basies uit 3 dele. Daar's in die eerste plek die ondernemer se interne eie koste en as 'n reël is hierdie kostes nie baie hoog nie. Dit sluit die dienste in wat die ondernemer lewer soos om die liggaam te bewaar en te versorg, die verskaffing van die kus en so meer. Dan is daar 'n tweede koste komponent wat die regsgedeelte is, kan 'n mens maar sê. Dit is die registrasie van die dood, die koop van 'n graf, die verrassingskoste, die doktersfooie en daai tipe van goed. En dit is ook nie eintlik regtig 'n groot bydraer tot hoë koste nie. Die grootste bydraer tot hoë koste is eintlik die familie se besondere behoeftes. Met ander woorde, die verskaffing van roumotors, die verskaffing van kos en markiestente en al hierdie tipe van goed kan tot 2 of 3 keer die werklike begrafniskoste beloop.
Hangata mona Afrika borwa. Lifu ha le hlahele le lapa fela. Empaki lifu la motse ka ofela le bohle ba tlileng le patong
umncwabo ugcina kuba indaba yomphakathi South Africa ngoba umuntu umezalwa umntwana umezalwa uzalelwa emphakathini silindele ukuthi kube umuntu ozokhuliswa na umphakathi loyo now uma eshona futhi umphakathi uba nengxenye endlalayo uzizwa u kunesuthi une part emele yenze ekutheni umphelezele lo muntu loyo that's why igcina kube into yomphakathi wonke ngoba eAfrica sithi umuntu akasindandana ene futhi sikhumbule nokuthi umndeni lo osuke ushonela wona awukhona ukwenza into ezithile ngoba uzilile manje umphakathi uyo ozonceda lo mndeni ududuza umndeni wonke hayi kuphela ngoba lo muntu kodwa ududuza umndeni wonke sokudinga umphakathi bonke uzokwazi umndeni ufile ukuthi uzuthi une yasupport lo mphakathi sinamasiko amaningi ajwayelekile emphakathini omnyama waseAfrika into ezifana nokuhlaba into ezivamile ukwenzeka uma umuntu eshonile masihlaba kaningi sisuke sipha umuntu umphanga ngishilo ngithi ngathi impilo uhambo eAfrika manje uma umuntu eseshona simpha umphanga ngabe kusahlaba ke ukuthi lo muntu ahambe nokudla kwakwenye ilizwe or endleleni yakhe suka ohambo suka lithatha
ho bohlokwa hore hang ka mora lepato setshaba se bokaneng mo sifumane ditjo
ngakho ukudla ke sizokudla nathi ngoba akakudli phela umuntu oshone nokudla udliwa yithi ukubonisa ukuthi sashera naye suka singisulu akuna mehluko ekutheni akuthi akuna whereby uthole ukuthi kunomkhawulo lapho khona ukuthi bayaphila noshonile sesingxenye yodwa Uma sidla sikhona nokuthi naye suthi Africa senze representation symbolically ukuthi lapho uma siyadla uyadla. Imili leyo sidlayo njoba kakhulu ukuthi abantu basinceda bafuna ukuhlisa i-dust. Ingakho ubona okuningi emakhaya esintwini sethu mandulo. Bekungakwenziwa into eziningi ukuze kufane nomshado, ubongezi nokudla ngaphandle, futhi bekungabi into ngoba asinzelanga abantu, abantu benzele ngoba bezele thina, thina sizelanga abantu, kodwa sizele thina ukuzokhapha umuntu wethu. Uma singayeka nje ukuthi senze izinto esingazazi, sigijimisa i-culture, asiyi-culture sisigijimisayo. Okukhona ekhaya kuyenziwa, nakhona okukhona kwenziwa nje, awuspend, overspend, wenza okukhona, awuboleki imali.
Baneng re sebedisa tjhelete engata tje ho pata bafu. Ebe sena se bakwa ke maikutlo. Ebe bohloko bo. O ka etsa hore re qetelle re sebedisa tjhelete eo re senang yona ho etsa lepato le majabajaba.
Wanneer dit by begrafnisse kom, dink ek mense verloor fokus met finansies. Want dis party mense het net daardie gedagte gaan van niks is te veel gevra om hierdie begrafnis of hierdie persoon te vereer nie. So ek dink nie hulle fokus is noodwendig finansies nie. Veral nie as die emosionele mense of die mense wat emosioneel reageer hierop is wat die begrafnisse reël nie. En emosionele spandering gebeur nie op 'n balansstaat nie. Dit gebeur nie op 'n logiese syfervlak nie. Wat baie belangrik is om te weet is dat enige besluit wat jy neem, of dit nou emosioneel of rationeel is, het soms finansiële gevolge wat blywend is.
Death and bereavement does make us vulnerable to making decisions that we regret later on. I don't think we should let financial decisions be a part of that. For your loved one will be gone and buried for years already, and you will still be paying off the loan that you took out to show how much you cared. And therefore, financial decisions should be taken in a clear, rational mind, in a settled, uncluttered space.
Een riglyn wat miskien belangrik is rondom finansiële aspekte wanneer dit by begrafnis kom, is om iemand te identifiseer wat 'n kenner is van finansies in die onmiddellike familiesirkel wat kan grense stel vir die spandabelrigheid. Dat daar nog steeds 'n gevoel is van ons spandeer, maar ons spandeer binne ons vermoë of binne sekere grense sodat ons nie vir onsself 'n tweede probleem veroorsaak later rondom die onkoste van die begrafnis nie.
Lifo ha sentho eo re ka itlopelang yona. Hangata re nanyetsa re sa ikemisetsa me re iphumana re ema le monna mateneng ha go utlwe gore na o ka boloka tšhelete ditshenyegelong tsa lepato jwang.
Kha ba kwame boradzimbulungo dzo fambananaho, kha ba dzhie tshifhinga u vhambedza tshumelo na mitengo ya boradzimutshara dzo fambananaho. Tsha phanḓa kha vha vhudzise mitengo. U wana mutevhe wa mitengo zwi thusa u dzhia tsheo kha tshumelo ine vha i ṱoḓa na ine vha si i ṱoḓe. Kha vha humbele u vhona zwoṱhe zwi re hone. Kanzhi, hu na thundu nnzhi dzine mitengo yadzo ya swikelelea fhedzi dzi songo kunguwedzwa. Vha ṱhogomele, vha humbule uri vha tshumelo dza mbulungo ndi vho ramabindu vhane vha ṱoḓa u ita masheleni. Zwi a konḓa u humbula zwavhuḓi musi wo ṱutshelwa nga shaka ḽa tsinisa. Hone, vha songo tenda tshiṅwe na tshiṅwe tshine vha khou vhudzwa. Arali vho vhaisala lune vha si kone u dzhia tsheo vha vhoṱhe, kha vha humbele thuso na thikhedzo kha muṅwe. U wana nyeletshedzo nnzhi nga u vhulunga masheleni nga tshifhinga tsha mbulungo, kha vha dalele Facebook page yashu na u sedza mobi friendly website yashu kha rentswithsense.co.za.
Hangata dikgwebo di leka ho nka monyetla ka ditsietsi le bohloko ba batho, ebe di a ba qhekanyetsa. Ha go utlwe dintlha tse ding hape ka sena.
o tla tseba gore khale batho ne ba patela felo mo go itseng e u bja ga go hlokofala ga ba re ba ya ba go begela modirishano wa bona gore meketeketo hlokofetse ba kra ile gore no o se busy le ditšhelete tša bona bja lo ke re batho ofisi e ngwe le ngwe yo o ikenang o lebelele mo lobotong gore go na le certificate sela setswa mo go financial services board se go se go fa matla le tumello ya gore o ka rekisetsa batho di funeral policy mohlambe ga se fonna go bolela gore ke bomang mare ke re ke nnete batho ba borena re tshwanetse re ba eletse gore dilo tsela ke di boletseng gore checka gore batho ba registerile gobane o kgona go hwetsa a funeral undertaker a re o a boloka mara a sena office ge batho ba gago ba tlhokofetse o thoma go ya kwa go ba bangwe gore le ka setswe le mpetse bodie ga a tloga o a sepela o ile go reka lepokisi o tloga moo o hira dikoloi jaaka le jaaka gore nonko nthuse ke na le funeral ke tshwanetseng ke dire ke bona di-conartist tse e leng gore ra di bona majaging a le gono mo di-funeral undertaker.
Ja, ek weet nie of 'n mens graag wil sê dat daar skelms rarig in die bedryf is nie, maar ongelukkig is ons maar soos enige ander bedryf. 'N Mens moet seker maak jy werk met mense wat lank in die bedryf is, mense wat al 'n reputasie opgebou het en ook mense wat aan die industrie organisasies behoort. Ons is lid van die Nasionale Begrafnisondernemers Assosiasie en as jy ooit 'n probleem met ons maatskappy sou kry, kan jy dit altyd na hulle toe verwys. Dit is belangrik om te weet dat die begrafnisbedryf nie gereguleer word nie. So tegnies kan amper enigiemand 'n begrafnisonderneming oopmaak. Maar daai persoon gaan nie noodwendig vir jou die diens en die satisfaksie kan lewer wat jy gaan kry by 'n maatskappy wat ou bande en wortels in die gemeenskap het nie. Mense behoort op te let daarna dat hulle polis moet deur 'n onderskrywer onderskryf word. Daar's baie veral ondernemers daar buite wat self 'n tipe van 'n versekering aanbied. Daai versekerings is egter nie onderskryf nie en dit kan risiko's inhou. As daai maatskappy môre toemaak, is jou polis weg. So maak seker is 'n maatskappy wat môre hier gaan wees, maak seker is 'n onderskryf deur 'n groot organisasie. Maak seker jou versekeraar is geregistreer by die Finansiële Dienste Raad.
Re sa tinya papatsong. Dula le rona. Re tswela pele go ithuta ka gore lefu le ama tšhelete le maikutlo a rona jwang. Re le amohela hape ho Rands with Sense. Lenaneho le fanang ka ditharollo tse bohlale go rarolla mathata a hao a tšhelete. Ka jeno re bua ka lefu. Le ho lahlehelwa ke moratuwa wa hao le hore sena se ama maemo a tšhelete jwang. Re utlwile ka ditshenyehelo tsa lefu tse kgolo gabe ga bona hore tshebediso e mpe ya tšhelete ha re lokisetsa tsa lefu e bakwa ke eng. Bothata bo boholo e ba ha re qetella re kena dikolotong ho etsa mokete wa lepato o majabajaba.
I think one has to sit down and literally, like with any loan, write down what your income is, write down what your expenses are, so that you can determine what it is that you can afford should you take out the loan, should you have to take out the loan in the first place. I think what one first has to do is say, what do I have available that is going to cost me no debt, that is not going to make me incur debt to give my loved one a proper send-off? If I only have the money available to have 50 people at my loved one's send-off and it's not going to put me in debt, is that such a bad thing? Do I really need to be entertaining 300 more guests? One has to ask the very important questions. Like with any other loan, do I really need to do this? People should remember that loans, whether taken out for funerals, whether taken out for studies, whether taken out for retail therapy, are expensive because of the often astronomical interest rates which are attached to it. Interest rates skyrocket, specifically when they are taken out with a micro lender, which is very often the case when people take out loans to cover a funeral. And loans become unrepayable and unaffordable because of these interest rates. And at the end of the day, your creditor does not care that you took out this loan as a tribute and as a sign of respect for your loved one. Your creditor just wants his money back. And in terms of grief and bereavement, the important question needs to be asked. Does it show that I loved and respected this person any more or any less by the amount of debt I incur because of his funeral?
Ha re boneng tsela tse ding tse ka re thusang ho qoba dikoloto ha re hlahelwa ke mafu.
Lomba nundu le utolobeleke ku ilomba. Unga setirisa mali ku lomba swilo swo fana ni switulu, swo dela na malepula ni mkwana. Ranga u vutisa vanhu lava u va tivaka. Ku lomba swilo leswi ka makhelwani swi ku pfuna ku hlayisa mali. Kombela ku pfuniwa ku tlula ku lomba mali. Kombela ku pfuniwa hi vamakwavo kumbe vangana ku tirhisa timovha ta vona ku tlula ku lomba mali no hayara swo famba. Kombela ku hlengeriwa mali. Loko munhu unwe anga nikela phakiti ra rhayisi, un'wana khavichi, aku heteleleni una swo ringana swo dya. Ku kuma vuxokoxoko, yana eka website ya hina rentswithsense.co.za kumbe Facebook page ya hina.
Ha motho a hlokahallwa ke molekane, a ka sarelwa moyeng, maikutlong le maemo a hae a tšhelete a ka fetoga. Lefu le ka baka phetoho e kgolo ka go panya ha leihlo le malapeng a nang le bogone.
Ons as mens is baie keer van mening dat ons ons toekomsplanne baie mooi agter mekaar het en dan ewe skielik sterf 'n geliefde. Dood is met ons, maar ons dinkie daaraan nie. En dit kan die mat heeltemal onder ons voete uitruk. Jou toekoms lyk nou baie donker en baie vaal, want jy weet nou nie wat jy gaan doen nie, want alles was so mooi uitgewerk en nou ewe skielik het jy geen plan meer nie. Of dit wat jy wel gedink het jy gaan doen, gaan nie realiseer nie. En jy moet aanvaar dat daai plan gaan anders lyk. En dit is nie altyd maklik om te aanvaar dat dit wat jy so mooi vir jouself uitgewerk het, nie meer gaan gebeur nie. Behalwe die emosionele trauma is daar praktiese realiteite. Die rekenings moet betaal raak, jy moet aangaan met jou lewe en jy het nie daai finansies om dit te doen nie.
Whenever there is a death in the family, irrespective of whether it's the breadwinner or not, it has a financial impact on the family. People don't sit down and think of the long-term implications of no longer having that family member available. People do not take the time to sit down and think, what was this family member's contribution towards the household, towards debt repayments, towards the finances of the household overall. So it is very often the scenario where people are taking out loans and still considering the contribution of the family member who is no longer there. It is always advisable to, as a family, get together, sit down and look at the financial situation now that that particular family member is no longer a part of the household finances. What are the implications short-term? What are the implications long-term? Things surely cannot just continue the way they were.
Haiba molekane wa hao o ne a laola tšhelete ya lona pele a hlokagala, go ka ba boima haholo go kena dieteng tsa hae. Ke ana mahlale a mmalwa a tla o thusang ha o thatafallwa nakong ena e bohloko haholo.
Qiniseka ukuthi kufanele ukhokhe ini. Qoqa onke amaphepha akho. Bese wenze uhlu lwezikweleti zakho ekumele uzibhadale ngenyanga. Izikweleti zakho ezibalulekile kakhulu kuzoba isikweleti sendlu, amakhadi wasebhangi, amakhadi kanye nemali mboleko. Ungavumeli ukuba izikweleti zakho zipakelane. Uma kunzima ukukhokha ngendlela efanele, xhumana namakhampani ngokusheshe. Yenza uhlu olusha lokwaba imali. Emva kokushona kwelunga lomndeni, izinto zizoshintsha ngakuwena. izindleko onazo zizoshintsha kunalezo ozijwayele. Yingakho kufuneka ukuthi wenze uhlu olusha lokwaba imali. Uma ufuna ukwazi kabanzi, vakashela urandswithsense.co.za noma uthande ikhasi lethu leFacebook ukuze uthole iseluleko esihle.
Kale amohela hape ho Rands with Sense. Lenane ho le buang ka maemo le mathata a tshelete. Ka jeno re bua ka ditshenyehelo tsa lefu le lepato. Re ka netefatsa joang hore baratuwa ba rona ba sala ba phela hantle ka mora hore re hlokahale. Ebe ho ngola wili ya hao fatshe ho ka bebofatsa maphelo a ba setseng morao.
Ukuba ne wili ba kubalulekile ngento enibili. Ukuqala ukuthi wena njengomuntu uphila uyakwazi ukutshela abantu ukuthi ufuna kwenzekeni uma usufile ngempahla yakho. Ngamazwi ukhetha abantu la sibiza ngama-S. Abazokwazi ukuthi kuyibona be-benefit. So uzothi u-ABC bazothola lokhu nalokhu nalokhu. I-advantage yokuqalileyo. Advantage yesibili ukuthi ukwazi ukukhomba noma ukhetha umuntu esimbiza ngokuthi i-executor. Lo muntu yena lo okwazi ukuthi umnike i-responsibility yokuthi lama assets la wakho uzowahambisa kanjani ngale ndlela okubale ngayo kwi-will. Shuthi umuntu omthembayo uma kumemba yomndeni ukuthi enze njalo noma umngani wakho. Ungabike ne-will okuyingozi ukuthi sibana lento esithi i-interstate succession. Okusho ukuthi wena njengomufi impahla yakho awuna control ukuthi yakubani. Because the Interstate Succession Act yisho ukuthi kuzobona mhlambe umndeni wakho inkosikazi kuya kwingane kuya kumkhulu kuya kugogo okusho ukuthi kulingana nokuthi unampahla engakanani. Akuhle lokho uma unabantu ofisayo ukuthi ba ubebona bathola impahla yakho uma usufile. Yingakho ke iwill ibalekile ngoba iwill ithi uma ngingasekho emhlabeni ngine control yokuthi kwenzekalani ngempahla zami. And kubalekile ukuba ne executor ngoba ukuba ne-executor kusho ukuthi umuntu omthembayo le ukuthi uzoyenza lento njengokufisa kwakho. Ngoba eSouth Africa sina lento esiyibiza ngokuthi i-freedom of testator. Ukuthi lo obhali will kumele kwenzeke iy'fiso zakhe. And i-executor le yenza isiqinisekayo ukuthi iy'fiso zalo muntu ofile ziyenzeka. Ukushada in community property ne kusho ukuthi abantu ababili uma beshada baza nalento esiyibiza ngokuthi ama-assets wabo ayahlangana emshadweni. Lento sibiza ukuthi kuba ne-joint estate. Kushuthi akukho lento ukuthi okwami okwakho, lento ukuthi kwami kwakho kwakho kwami. Uma umuntu efileke without a will, into enzekalayo la ukuthi i-master, ama-assets wabo azofreezwa, i-joint estate. Okubuhlungu ukuthi lo munye-ke osaphila ngeke akwazi ukuthi a-access-e i-joint estate le. Izofreezwa bese iya-reportwa ku-estate yokuthi sekushoniwe. And then lo oselo phila ngeke akwazi ukuthi athole i-share yakhe la emshadweni until kuze kukhokhwe iy'kweletu ze-estate. Because akusona isikweletu salo muntu ofile, isikweletu sabo bethu. So babili-ke kwase kukhokhiwe, then ikhane izothola-ke i-share yakhe. Uma umuntu efa, sinama-estate amabili. Khona i-insolvent estate, okusho ukuthi iy'kweletu zingaphezu kwale mpahla labantu abanayo umufi nalosele. Bese kuba khona i-solvent estate okusho ukuthi iy'kweletu zingaphansi kwale mpahla abanayo bobabili abayenzile. Uma ingaphansi-ke kwe-estate le akunankinga, bazokhokhelwa abantu bese kuthi okusalayo kuzonikwa-ke laba abasele kuthiwa ama-S. Kodwa uma iy'kweletu zingaphezulu kuzomele kudayiswe izindlu uma kunezindlu iy'moto. Bese ke kukhokhelwa ikweletu ze-estate. Okungenzeka ukuthi nomuntu naye lo sela ngasale ngasaphethe lutho ngenxa yokuthi i-estate le iyakoloda ngoba nishade in community of property. Akukho futhi inkinga lapho ngoba noma ushada in community of property kuyenzeka ukuthi ube ne-separate estate yakho noma nishade in community ngoba sinalento esibiza ukuthi ama-half share. Uhafu wakho, uhafu walo muntu uyahlangana bese kuba i-joint estate. Okusho ukuthi uma eshona omunye i-estate yakho le awukwazi ukuthola izinto until kukhokhwe ama debt.
Sesotho seri lifu leqoleng yakho. Ho hlophisa maemo a hao a tshelete o saphela. E ka ba mpho e kgolo ho ba lelapa la hao ha o se o hlokahetse.
I think the best thing that we can do if an expensive funeral in your culture, in your tradition is required, is to have a savings policy in place, is to have a funeral policy in place.
Ek dink is belangrik dat mense 'n begrafnispolis uitneem terwyl hulle jonk is. In die eerste plek betaal jy goedkoper vir meer dekking en in die tweede plek weet ons nie regtig of ons gaan 80 jaar oud word nie. Dit is ook belangrik dat jy moet spandeer wat jy kan bekostig. Ons kan altyd later teruggaan en weer na jou polis gaan kyk en dit uitbrei en groter maak. Jy gaan in elk geval sekerlik jou polis verander wanneer jy trou, kinders kry, dalk skoonouers moet begin verseker, jou eie ouers wil verseker. So dit is belangrik om te besef dat jou polis is 'n lewende ding. Dit moet saam met jou groei en saam met jou lewe tred oor tyd. Die reeks van beskikbare produkte is so groot dat dit kan omtrent enigiets insluit wat die kliënt sou wou hê. Vanaf die aanvanklike verwydering van die oorledene na ons perseel tot die reëlingskonferensie met die familie, die uitkies van 'n kus, die registrasie van die sterfte, die lewering van produkte wat eintlik eers na die tyd na die begrafnis gebruik word, soos byvoorbeeld die voorsiening van kos en tente, tafels, stoele. Daar's geen reël wat sê dat jy al die geld hoef te spandeer aan die begrafnis nie. Ons weet dat nadat 'n broodwinner afgesterf het, daar altyd behoeftes is rondom die gesin wat agterbly, kinders wat moet gaan studeer en jy kan jou polis laat uitbetaal sonder om dit alles aan die begrafnis te spandeer.
Ho ba le funeral policy ho ka imolla morwalo wa lifu haholo. Empa etsa dipatlisiso. O be le bonnete hore o seke wa iphumana o le mathateng a fetang ao o na le ngona.
Wanneer jy dit oorweeg om 'n begrafnispolis uit te neem, dink ek is dit baie belangrik om jou eie behoeftes te oorweeg. Wie is dit wat jy graag wil verseker? Vir hoeveel wil jy daai persoon verseker? Gaan jy regtig verantwoordelik wees vir die begrafniskoste? Gaan jy net 'n bydrae maak tot daai begrafniskoste? In verskillende kulture maak verskillende mense in die familie voorsiening vir om mense te begrawe. Ek dink in die algemeen is dit belangrik dat 'n mens moet kyk na jou eie gesin, die aard van die saak, jou eggenoot, jou kinders, jou ouers, jou skoonouers en dan mag dit wees dat jy mense in jou familie het, uitgebreide familielede, 'n oom of 'n tante vir wie niemand anders voorsiening maak nie en wie die verantwoordelikheid na jou toe sal kom om op die ou en daai begrafnis te betaal. Dit is ook belangrik om te besef dat alles word duurder. Ons weet inflasie maak dat ons iets wat 10 jaar terug R5 gekos het nou R50 kos. En vir daai rede moet jy op 'n gereelde basis met jou finansiële adviseur gesels en seker maak dat die produkte wat in plek is nog steeds aan jou behoeftes voldoen. Ek dink is altyd belangrik dat 'n mens probeer om 'n polis te gaan uitneem by iemand wat jy regtig kan vertrou. Iemand met 'n goeie reputasie, iemand wat lankal in die besigheid is, iemand wat geregistreer is by die FSB en die ander industrieowerhede. En dan dink ek behoort te mense gaan sien, is hierdie 'n polis wat regtig voldoen aan my behoeftes? Ons kry dit baie algemeen dat mense 3 en 5 en 8 polisse uitneem en elkeen van hulle spreek een of ander individuele stukkie behoefte aan. Pleks dat hy een polis of twee dalk het wat al sy verskillende behoeftes kan aanspreek. Elke polis het uit die aard van die saak poliskoste en is daarom belangrik dat jy die aantal polisse so laag hou as moontlik.
Re ile ra kopa tlhahiso leseding ho setsebisa rona.
Ha re bua ka di-insurance, ke rata hape ho hlokomedisa mabapi le funeral policies. Funeral policy di fall under insurance, di wela ka tlasa lesaka la di-insurance. Now, for many years, most of the funeral policies pay out ya teng ene e ba bo 5,000, 10,000. Maybe 20. Now, ha ke tla sheba le pato hore le tlo mpatla tshelete kae? 20,000 e mohlomong ha ya lekana. So ke batla more. That is why ke bana le 1 le tsepedi le ya boraro mohlomong le ya bona le botlhano. Because re na le di funeral policy tse mmalwa. Ha
ke tobana le mathata a tshelete ke setse ke thoma ho skipa ha ke sa dipatala kgwedi le kgwedi tseding ha o ka skipa ha be di fela setse ba e cancel ha e ba o na le mathata di tshelete rather ba letsetse o bue le bona re ke tla palla ho patela kgwedi ena empa ho lokile ha kgwedi e tlang ke patela ha bedi ba dumele botsa hape hore ha nke sa kgone kgwedi tse pedi ho lokile na kgwedi ya boraro ha ba dumela o lokile because ba bang ba qakana le taba ha ba fitla mona hore ka kgwedi ya boraro ba rena ho harisa dikena ma motla starta afresh o tla kena ho waiting period o kene ho di exclusions tsele tse o kopaneng le tsona wa feta ho tsona right at the beginning so make that phone call today otherwise o tlo lahlahelwa ke di contributions tsa hao kapa tjhelete ya hao o setse o ipatetse dijara tse ngata yabe le hore di nwelletse kaofela
ha eba tsena di etsa hore o ngongorehe ka bokamoso ba hao le ba lelapa la hao re na le dikeletso tse ntle tse ka o thusang e ba le rona hape ho Rands with Sense ka mora papatso ha re tswella pele ho bua ka keletso tsena. Re le amohela hape lenanehong lena le o thusang ho etsa Rands with Sense. Ha o hlokahala, lelapa la hao le ka nna la iphumana le hloleha ho iphedisa le ho lefella ditlhoko. Mme life insurance e ka ba tswella molemo.
Life insurance is essentially a policy contract whereby a provider will pay you a lump sum or a cash lump sum on the death of the life insured. And in return for that, the life insured pays the policy provider a monthly premium up until the point that they die. Life insurance is extremely important for every individual to consider because it will cover a number of needs. You know, the first being that if they have any debt, that they'll be able to cover that debt on their death. And then obviously to consider the outcome to your family and ensuring that your loved ones are protected after you're gone and are able to continue living the lifestyles that they currently live. When you take out a life insurance policy, what you've got to be sure to do is to nominate the beneficiaries, like your spouse or your children, that you want the payouts or the policy proceeds from the policy to go to on death, so that you can ensure that they have access to the money that they need within a few days or within 24 hours of you having passed away. In the event of a death in the family, the beneficiaries or the remaining family members can then either contact their financial advisor or they can contact the provider directly to notify them of the death and notify them of the claim. And they will then be told exactly how to submit the claim process going forward. It's a very straightforward process in, you know, 90% of cases, and the claims are usually approved and processed extremely quickly. Many of the providers in the market will pay almost all their claims within 24 hours. When you are considering taking out life insurance, don't be fooled into thinking that life insurance is only important for older people. We've seen the statistics that specifically in South Africa with our road accident rate, younger people are dying at an alarming rate, and it's never too early to think about life insurance and your needs on death, even at an early age, for your loved ones that are left behind still need to be covered.
Jwale, ho bohlokwa ho tshireletsa baratuwa ba hao ka ho kgetha policy e nepahetseng le hore o e hlokomele hantle. Ke ena tlhahiso leseding e ka o bolokelang tjhelete.
Dira dinyakishisho. Tia nako go lebelela gore o tle o be le dikgetho tse ntshi tse di tlogo go swanela. Tseba gore o nyaka policy ya gago e go direle eng. Ge o le gare o lebelela, putisha dipotsiso, dipolicy, ga se dilo tse di bonagalago go ya ka mo batho ba naganago ka gona. Bala fine print. Tšhaba go tšea dipholisi tše ntši. Sebakeng sa go tšea pholisi ya leloko le lengwe le le lengwe le lelapa. Tšea e tee yeo e dumelelago go oketša maloko. Pholisi e nngwe le e nngwe ye o e tšeago e na le koketšo ya dipatelwa tša administration. Ge o nyaka tshedimošetšo ye le go ya pele, tsenago rantswithsense.co.za goba go letlakala la Facebook.
O seke wa lebala dintlha tsena tse molemo. The Burial Society ke mekgatlo ya lepato e tlwaelegileng metseng ya rona, e re thusang ha lefu le hlaha. Maloko a dumellana ka tšhelete e itseng eo ba e patalang kgwedi le kgwedi, mme e be tšhelete ena e bolokwa bankeng. Ha go tlwe dintlha tse ding hape ka sena.
Yo, di Burial Society stokvel according to me kinto A1 fela wa tshwana Burial Society le stokvel. They've been around as early as bo e ka di 1930s. The Burial Society hangata di qala ka hore le tla kopana le 10 or whatever the number is, le formalize a society ya lona ka constitution ya lona e le dumellanang ka yona. For example, le tla dumelana hore ka kgwedi motho tla contributor 100 rand. Then be le hlalosa re tšhelete eo na ha ke hlokahaletswe ke batho be ke ba ngodisitseng ko bukeng. You have to identify specific people so bo batlang o thole thuso mhlang so hlaileng lefu. Ha o hlaile lefu, members of the Burial Society will come together to help one ka bomme ba tlo thusa ho pheha. And then her lichelete that you have been contributing, it gets withdrawn and then you get a portion of that money as per tumelwano ya lona ha ne liqala Burial Society.
Well, I think issues of costs in the African society, the African economy is supposed to be based on a collective will and a collective cooperation. So obviously where those institutions are not well functioning, which could be due to many factors, political, historical, and of course socioeconomic as well. Any event can be quite a heavy task for a family to take on. But where societies are integrated, the main cost should not actually fall on us as the bereaved family. It should be something that the community come together to take up the costs for and to finance. Obviously, as history has passed, many of us have become more individualistic, or we have become families that are not as connected as we were in the past. So it becomes a concern. Who picks up the bill? How do you finance this?
Yo, ibuhloko haholo trend eo ya di expensive funerals. Batho ba ikenya dikoloteng, again ke yona ntho etsang batho ba gutlele ho mashonisa. Kore trend e ya expensive funerals ke societal pressure, metswalle, batho ba reka makase a expensive. They cook a lot of food, which in my view it's not necessary. Le diaparo, ba bang se bile ba tsamaya ba ile nka diaparo tse ntšha ba itukisetsa ho ya lefung.
Go bohlokwa hore re seke ra iphumana re reka dintho tseo re sa di hlokeng bakeng sa lepato, hobane fela re batla go hlahella ka mahetla. Hobane o ka iphumana o le mathateng a fetang ao o shebaneng le ona. Ha re yeng papatsong, re tla utlwa karabo ha re kgutle. Ka le amohela hape mona ho Rands with Sense. Lenane ho le re thusang hore re nahane hantle mabapi le tšhelete. Ka jeno re bua ka mafu, mme re bona le hore a ama maemo a rona a tšhelete jwang.
We have seen that funerals have also become a place to show off, a place to show off wealth, a place to show off clothes, a place to pick up a new date. All kinds of different agendas plays out in today's funerals. And I think
You can dismiss that on one level and just say that that's just materialistic culture and it's nonsense on one way, in one way. But in another way, I think it's also a symbolic reflection of what life has become. So the opportunities that I get to show off or to actually be present, I would call it that, I would grasp them. And in this world, it does matter when you have a big car. People actually look at you when you have a big car. People will become want to become your friends, maybe not for the right reasons, but you get a glimpse and you get a small experience of what it seemed to mean to be somebody. And if I only have a small window to get that, I'm gonna go for that. And even if that means I'm gonna mix it in with my funerals and my family rituals, I might go for that because it gives me a small window to be somebody, to articulate that I also matter. We are from a family. You should recognize us. We also are alive.
It really is a vicious cycle of people thinking that they need to impress friends, they need to impress families. And that is what very many funerals are being used for. It is being used as a platform to uplift your social status, which is exactly what your credit card is being used for when you buy expensive gadgets and clothing that you don't use. It is a platform to uplift your social standing. And as a society, we actually have to start worrying when we are using death as a platform to uplift our social standing.
Ubaluleka nje komncwabo ukuthi kahle lesifuna ukuphelezelwa umufi wethu ngendlela eright esifile ukuthi nathi uyajabulela khona mhlambe umoya wakhe uzophumula ngoqolo. Akusika kahle hle ukuthi kumele sibonise umphakathi ukuthi thina sikhona kangakanani. Ngoba iqiniswe nje ukuthi umoya nje wodwa awona ndaba nokuthi wenzeni ilitshe elingakanani nebhokisi elingakanani nokudla okungakanani. Umoya nje wodwa uma sikhuma ngokuxhumana komoya nenhliziyo zethu ujabulela nje ukuthi siqolile, siyazwisisa ukuthi unohambo nathi sikunengxenye esiyidlalile ekutheni uma uhambe kahambe kahle umuntu wethu. Akekho futhi umuntu engicabanga ukuthi uma anothando lomndeni wakhe angafisa bangene ey'nkingeni zemali ngoba bafisa phelezela yena.
I think we are at a time where we as African people should also think very carefully about what is our relationship with the material world and the spiritual world. Does it mean, for instance, that when we spend more on consultations, on rituals, on what we can kind of show off, does that mean we become more protected? Does it mean that our spirituality is more protected, more announced, more secure? I think it doesn't. I think African spirituality is simple. It's not related much to money or to costs or to or something that can only be done for a particular class or a particular income group. It actually unites us across those barriers, and it's the place that we can find a communal space, regardless of our income differences and our material possessions. So I think when we remember aspects like this, material possessions becomes very irrelevant and very unnecessary to use as a way to create separation and to create different layers between us as people, because I feel that's what material possessions does. It tells us in a way who's supposedly important, who has and who doesn't have. So I think if we sink into and remember what our rituals were about, it was not about showing off, it was not about being better than anyone else. It was about actually diffusing all those levels of imbalance and difference and come together as being one.
My appeal is that let us try and use chelete ya rona e rebasing in a modest way. Lifu ukaleza libe decent without ho oetse dintho tse makase a turang le dijo tse ngata di salad tsa mefuta futa e fapaneng. So ko re fela ha re nahana the still life after the funeral.
Begrafnisse is regtig baie belangrik. Dit is die proses wat jy deurgaan, dit is die afskeid neem van 'n persoon. En jy wil eer betoon en jy wil daar wees. Maar dit hoef jou nie finansiëel lam te lê vir die res van jou lewe dalk nie.
Hasimohe, ho na le tsela tse ngata tse ka o thusang hore o etse rents with sense, ho hlophisetsa lepato. E bang le rona hape bekeng e tlang, ha re bua ka monna ya mathateng ka mora ho sebedisa tjhelete ya hae bohlaswa. ke nna Mmarona Kgwele. Ya le hopotsang mekgwa e meraro ya ho netefatsa hore le ba le bolokolohi mabapi le tjhelete tsa lona. Ya pele, sebedisa tjhelete e tlase ho mokgolo wa hao. Ya bobedi, fumana tsela tse ding tsa ho iketsetsa tjhelete. Ya boraro, etsa dintho tsena bobedi ba tsona ka mehla. MaAfrika Borwa, dulang le letjhatsi ka tjhelete ya lona. Salang hantle.